And good morning and welcome to Mike Ferry TV. It is the week of June 10th. Okay, every May and June, probably for the last 15 years, I do a tour of California, Nevada, into Arizona, Utah, talking to our 60 best real estate brokerage clients. And I do a three-hour seminar, and it's my way of giving back to our best customers some information. And at the end of that seminar, I invite everybody to attend our Superstar Retreat, which I enjoy. Not only do I enjoy being with the people during the tour, but I really enjoy inviting them to the retreat, and I enjoy doing the retreat for those that are able to attend. But I want to share with you something that happened. Probably it was around the third week in the month of May. At 9 o'clock in the morning, when I start speaking for 3 hours, if you look at your watch, when it's 9 o'clock in the morning, I start. Whether the room is full or half empty, I start. If you come to Mike Ferry events, we always start on time. We're fanatical about starting on time. Many of our competitors start when the audience gets there. They start when the room is full. I don't do that. I have too much respect for those that are on time. So a couple weeks ago, probably it's been now about 3 weeks, a young man approaches me at the break. And I'm always open to answering questions and participating with the people in the room. And the young man said to me, could I have a copy of your notes from today? And I said, okay, why? Well, I didn't get here till 9:30. I missed a lot. And I wish you would have waited and started till we all got here. And I smiled and said, well, thank you for that thought. But I have a personal policy that I'm very punctual. I start on time. And I said, I noticed today you, as did probably 30 other people out of the 150, show up between 9:15 and 9:30. He goes, well, yeah, there was traffic and I was late getting out of the office and I was calling people on the phone and I was working on a deal and, you know, all the normal things that happen that cause people to be late. Well, when I got back to my office later that day, there happened to be something that was sent to me, and I apologize, I don't remember who sent it, and it was regarding punctuality. So I'm going to read this to you, okay? Punctuality. Consistently being on time is the product of proper planning, personal discipline, and a respect for other people's time. Punctuality is being on time. It's the product of proper planning, planning what your day is going to be like. Okay, I have to drive 4 miles to get to that Mike Ferry meeting, and there's usually a lot of traffic, so if I leave at 9:05, I'm going to be late. Proper planning. Personal discipline, which is a big thing in being a professional anything, much less real estate person, and a respect for other people's times. Then it goes on to say, making a habit of being late demonstrates none of these three things and is often the sign of patchy priorities and being selfish. Making a habit of being late demonstrates none of these three things I just said and is also a sign of patchy priorities and being selfish. Habitual lateness says, my time is more valuable than yours. Learn to be reliable and a person of integrity by adopting the discipline necessary to be on time. Many years ago, I did a very intense, very expensive, I think I spent about $175,000 interviewing 2,000 people in the public, and I hired a company to do this for me. And I put together, I think it was 35, 40 questions, and I went to a company that does surveys, and I said, what's it going to cost me to interview 2,000 people, ask all these questions, tabulate the results, bring it back to me? I want to have a better understanding, if I'm going to be a good speaker, trainer, and coach, of how the public looks at and views professional real estate people. So I contracted this company to put this report together for me. They talked to 2,000 people. It was a university that I contacted, and they put students out on the street, and they were doing the surveys, and they got just under 2,000 surveys completed. Then they put it all together and tabulated it and gave me a book this thick, 8.5 by 11. And there were two things the public said about our industry of real estate. Number one, and probably the most important, real estate people never call us back. This survey was done 20 years ago. That problem has accelerated in a much worse fashion than before. Real estate people don't call us back. We list our home for sale with somebody. We don't hear from them until we call them. they're going to get us information on the mortgage. They never call us back. We call and leave two messages regarding some part of the transaction. We don't hear from them. I don't get it. Why do we not call people back? We have an obligation to communicate. We have an obligation to talk, an obligation to respond, an obligation to be there for them because they're paying us what becomes our livelihood, which is commission checks. We're trying to offer the best service possible to buyers and sellers, and too often we won't communicate. We won't call them back. But then the second thing, and the survey was this thick, probably 250 pages. I mean, it drove me crazy going through all this material that I was able to accumulate for the money I spent. But the second thing they said, real estate people are always late, and it drives us crazy. So let me ask you a question. All right, you got a listing appointment next week at 4 o'clock on Tuesday. Is the seller going to be nervous before you get there? And the answer is yes. Are you nervous trying to get there? The answer is yes. And if you're late, does it create more stress and nervousness on behalf of the seller? The answer is yes. But if you're 4 or 5 minutes early, some of that stress is relieved. So watch, out of respect for other people, I'm always on time or I'm always early. And most people have very little respect for themselves. I know you respect yourself, and therefore you respect other people. So therefore, being on time, being punctual, is a vital part of the process. And yet, 20 years ago, the public said real estate people simply are never on time, and they don't communicate. There's not a valid reason why you and I cannot be on time and communicate better with people. Because the higher the level of communication, the more response we get, the more listings we take, the more money we make. And think about this. When we're on time, we reduce stress not only within ourselves, we reduce the stress within the people we're going to meet. So to be respectful to the buyers, to be respectful to the sellers, and be respectful to yourself, let's always be 5 minutes early. Well, we've now spent about 7.5 minutes, which is a lot of your time on this particular message today. Go have a great week. By the way, if you want to go to our Superstar Retreat, call the office. We'd love to have you there. Thanks for today.